Do you sometimes need to return purchased merchandise to your vendors? Well, in that case, you should watch this video, Vendor Refunds from Merchandise Purchases. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Refunds from merchandise purchases can be very simple if it was a refund or return from an original purchase where you received a bill. This means if you purchased it on credit, then it's very simple to record returning it. However, if you are returning merchandise that was paid for by cash and not credit, there are two additional steps that you would have to follow. Let's discuss refunds from credit purchases first. These are purchases when you recorded a bill when you got the merchandise with the bill. The refund should be recorded by making a credit memo. Credit memo should have the same items as the original vendor's bill that came with the purchase. The effect of the credit memo is the exact opposite of the effect of receiving the bill with the merchandise. The inventory quantity will decrease because if you returned items to the vendor, you have fewer items available for sale. And the inventory asset will also decrease, and of course, because you're returning something that you paid for on credit, your accounts payable will also decrease. For example, let's imagine on July 15th of 2019, we returned 5 bananas back to Sam's Farm from bill number 1717 that we received on June 2nd, 2015. I know that was a long time ago, but let's just go along with the story. The inventory account will decrease by $100 because we paid $100 originally when we purchased those 5 bananas. The inventory quantity for bananas will, of course, decrease by 5. And the unpaid bill report will show the credit memo until it is applied to the original bill. Then we will apply the credit to the bill, and of course we will be reviewing a little bit about what we learned in the accounts payable section. So let's leave this slide up and read from it step by step. We click vendor, enter bill, and then we change the bill to a credit. Now, once you change the bill window to a credit, you then choose the vendor, it was Sam's Farm, and the date that we returned it was July 15th of 2019. And now, what items are we returning? We are returning bananas. And we are returning 5 bananas, making a total of $100. So, this is how you would make the credit for the return of items that you received with a bill. Now, we click Save and Close, and now, of course, we can check the inventory report and see that the quantity of the bananas went down and we by $100 by 5 bananas, and we know that will happen in the inventory account and the trial balance. But regarding the accounts payable, we have to look at reports, vendors and payables, unpaid bills, and you can see, press A for all, you can see for Sam's Farm, there's this matzo ball hanging out there, unapplied. It's a credit that's supposed to be applied to the actual bill. And it says it should be applied to bill number 1717.
Let's go back. Yes, because it was a return from the merchandise that we received with bill number 1717. And we will apply the credit in the pay bills window. So now we have the credit, and bill number 1717 has a $1,100 balance. But when we apply them together, this credit will disappear from the unpaid bills report, and bill number 1717 will go down to $1,000 even. So again, we use the pay bills window just to apply the credit. We click Vendor, Pay Bills, and of course, the date of the return stays the same, 7/15 of 2019. The vendor is Sam's Farm, so we see only unpaid bills for Sam's Farm. Now we have to check this bill, and we are not paying the bill. After you check the bill, we have to click Set. You see, once we click on the bill, you see there's $100 of credit available. So we click Set Credit. And of course, normally there'd be a list of several credits that we would choose from. But since there's only one, QuickBooks clicks the check mark to select the only one we can. When we click Done, you will see that here's the credit used, and here, and it assumes, be very careful, it assumes that you are paying the rest of the bill. If you are not, make the amount you're paying down to zero. This way, you are only applying the credit without paying the rest of the bill, which is what is happening. So we click Pay Selected Bill, and then just click Done, and you can see in the unpaid bills report, the credit disappeared because it has been applied, and the unpaid bill has decreased by $100, and it's $1,000 even. And now we will see what it's like to do a purchase return for something that we paid for immediately. First, you would make a credit memo the same way we did a moment ago, as if we were returning something from a credit purchase that we received with a bill. Then we record the money we received into the deposit window on the day the vendor's refund money goes into the bank. And the last step would be to apply the credit memo to the deposit so that the vendor reports are clean. Specifically, the unpaid bill report will not show any evidence of this transaction because both the deposit and the credit memo will be applied to each other so that the vendor's balance will be unchanged as a result of this transaction. For example, let's imagine on July 20 of 2019, we returned 5 apples to Addie's Orchard back from che the check we gave her on May 24th in 2015. And she gave us check number 2525 for $50. The inventory account will decrease, and the inventory quantity for apples will decrease by 5. And the unpaid bill report will show the credit memo until it is applied to the deposit. So let's go ahead and record the credit. From the main menu, click Vendors, enter Bill, and then click Credit. Once it changes to credit, we make sure we put the date that we were instructed, July 20 of 2019, because that's the day we gave back the 5 apples. We gave them back to Addie, and the item that we gave back was apples, and the quantity was 5. Now, after we click Save and Close, of course, we can open the inventory valuation detail and see that the quantity of apples has decreased by 5. But more importantly, we can open the unpaid bill report and look at Addie, and you see that it did affect her balance. We have $50 decreasing Addie's balance, and that shouldn't be because she paid us. She gave us the money. So let's imagine here on July 21, We deposited check number 2525 from Addie for the $50 of apples that we returned. Well, that's very simple. Banking, make deposit. And we're not depositing one of the customer's payments, so you can close this. The date that we deposited her check was July 21, and you must click Received from Addie's Orchard. You must tell QuickBooks whom you received the money from when you're depositing it. Now, here's the interesting point. The from account, pay close attention. The from account is accounts payable. Accounts payable, because anytime you affect the vendor's balance, any vendor's balance, it affects the accounts payable account. And now the amount that's going into the bank is $50. If you want to understand more about this, you can watch the accounts payable section right here on this website. But anytime you deposit money from a vendor, the account is accounts payable. Now, when we click Save and Close, you can see that both the credit and the deposit are canceling each other out for the vendor's balance. So even if this were a vendor whom we never received bills from, this would be the way to do it. They would have a negative balance at the moment we gave back the merchandise, and then when we deposit their money for the refund, that would wipe out the